71 साल माघ 24 गते शनिबार थियो त्यो दिन उहाँले शनिबार चाहिँ उहाँहरूको आइतबार बिदा भयो भने शनिबार सुप्रिम कोर्ट बार एसोसिएसनमा प्रोग्राम गर्नुभएको थियो र नेपाललाई उहाँले एकदम राम्रो सम्मान गर्नुभयो र त्यहाँ चाहिँ सबभन्दा पहिला वक्ताको रूपमा चाहिँ म पुगेको रहेछु र त्यसपछि उहाँले यो जुन 2018 डिसेम्बर 9/24/25/26 जुन कार्यक्रम गर्नुभयो त्यो चाहिँ हाम्रो नेपालको लागि गौरवको कुरो हो र नेपाल भारतको सम्बन्धको विषयमा जहिले पनि हामीहरू एउटा शङ्का गर्ने र भारतको एउटा दृष्टिकोण र त्यो दृष्टिकोणको बिचमा हामी के हो त भन्दाखेरि हामी भने वेद बनेको देश हौँ, शिवजीको देश हो, त्यो संसारको सबभन्दा पहिला डकुमेन्ट सबभन्दा यो राष्ट्रको लागि संसारकै लागि चाहिँ उद्गम स्थल भएको हुनाले हाम्रो जुन एउटा डिग्निटी छ, सम्मान छ, हैसियत छ र हाम्रो जुन सुरुवात हौँ र गीता भगवान् कृष्णले 5000 वर्ष अगाडि जुन गीता भन्नुभयो त्यो गीता चाहिँ वेदको सार हो र त्यसले गर्दाखेरि हाम्रो आफ्नो मर्यादा आफ्नो ऋषिमुनिहरू 38,000 ऋषिमुनिले जुन संसारलाई एउटा दर्शन दिनुभएको छ त्यही दर्शनको आधारमा चलेका छ र त्योप्रति उहाँहरू पनि नतमस्तक हुनुहुन्छ र जति पनि उच्च स्तरीय भारतीय कानुन व्यवसाय मित्रहरू उहाँहरू बडो खुसी हुनुभयो उहाँले तपाईँ शिवजीको देशबाट आउनुहुन्छ भनेर उहाँले धेरै सम्मान गर्नुभएको थियो र त्यो ठुलो अर्गनाइजेसन किन त नेपाल बार एसोसिएसन भन्दाखेरि मैले पहिला पनि भन्ने गरेको थिएँ हाम्रो सबभन्दा नजिकको राष्ट्र भारतको चाहे राजनीतिक रूपमा हामी जेसुकै हौँ त्यसले गर्दाखेरि भारतको पनि हामी कानुन व्यवसायको नाताले हामीहरूको सबभन्दा नजिकको त को भन्दाखेरि अधिवक्ताको लागि अधिवक्ता नै हो नेपाल बार एसोसिएसनको लागि भारत बार एसोसिएसन नै हो त्यसले गर्दा भारतको सबभन्दा ठुलो संस्थाको चाहिँ आउनुभएको छ र उहाँहरूको एउटा विचार के थियो भने नेपालको भारतको सम्बन्ध चाहिँ हामीले कसरी बढाउन सकिन्छ र नेपालको जुन डिग्निटी छ त्यो हिन्दुत्व छ त्यसपछि जुन त्यो जुन 140 भन्दा बढी चाहिँ जातिहरू छ 160 भन्दा भाषा छ र त्यो सबै कुरा लगायत भारत चाहिँ अब सन् 2030 विश्वको महाशक्ति बन्दैछ र त्यो महाशक्ति बन्ने क्रममा भारतले जतिसुकै जेसुकै गरे पनि त्यसलाई नियन्त्रण दिनको लागि नेपालबाट उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ कुनै न कुनै एउटा आध्यात्मिक रूपमा उहाँहरू आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान लिनको लागि नेपालमा आउनुहुन्छ यो देवभूमि तपोभूमि भएको कारणले र एउटा तपाईँहरूलाई थाहा छ अहिले भारतमा बिजेपीले जसरी चाहिँ फेरि जितेको छ र प्रधानमन्त्री नरेन्द्र मोदी 2 वर्ष नेपालमा आएर बस्नुभयो त्यो कुरो त बाहिर प्रकाश नआएर सत्य तथ्य यही नै हो त्यसरी भारतका जति पनि विद्वान छन् हामीले इतिहासदेखि यो पवित्र भूमिमा भगवान् कृष्ण आउनुभएको छ हनुमान आएको छ त्यसपछि गुरु गोविन्द आउनुभएको छ त्यसपछि गौतम बुद्ध आउनुभएको छ यो पवित्र भूमि हो यहाँ नआएकन कुनै पनि संसारको म आध्यात्मिक व्यक्ति हुँ म चाहिँ ज्ञानी हुँ भन्ने मान्छेको चाहिँ त्यो पूर्ण हुँदैन तर त्यस्तै गोर्खा सेना हाम्रो नेपालको संसारको अहिले रुलिङ गर्ने सेना भने गोर्खा सेना नम्बर वान यो सबै कारणले उहाँहरू प्रभावित हुनुभएको छ र हामीले उहाँहरूलाई दिन सक्ने हो र हाम्रो आफ्नो स्वाभिमान राखेर राजनीति एउटा पाटो मात्र होइन कि हाम्रो अरू कानुनको छ जस्तो हाम्रो आफ्नै संसारको सबभन्दा पुरा कानुन चाहिँ हाम्रो नेपालबाट ल्याउने यसलाई चाहिँ हामीले चाहिँ यो कन्स्टिट्युसन एन्ड पोलिटिक्स इन साउथ एसिया यसले चाहिँ धेरै कुरामा चाहिँ गर्नु अलिक प्रकाश पारिदिनु हुनुको लागि र यही विषय चाहिँ मैले प्रकाश पारेको छु यसको कार्यक्रम अघाडि बढाइदिनु हुन्छ डक्टर हाम्रो सरोज घिमिरेजीलाई हार्दिक अनुरोध गर्छु धन्यवाद
Remarkable concept development in this country. Without any bloodshed, we got lots of power. After restoration democracy, we had a mean constitutions. But every moment, every political moment that we had was very peaceful. And Nepal Bar Associations is basically founded on 4 principles: rule of law, independence of judiciary, human rights, and the professional development of lawyers. So we have a new leadership in the Nepal Bar Associations, a very dynamic leadership with a competent team into that one. And we are very proud that this is the first committee that Nepal Bar Association has formed, the International Relations Committee, where the Bar Association trusted Professor Kunaman Sake and me to have in this committee and take. So we are pleased to carry the first committee from the first program from the Committee of International Relations. And I really appreciate for these reports for the Nepal Bar Association. And without any longer, I request Professor Poonaman Sakya to deliver his few remarks on the constitutional development and basic future constitution that we promulgated.
Our relationship with India is not at the level of government to government only. It is at the level of people to people. The government may fight, but we people of Nepal and India, we have so much close relationship that governments may come and go, but the people's relationship will always remain there. So, our relationship no government or no party can wipe away. That's the reality. Because we have a history, we have a historical relationship with India, and that fact is carried by the fact that we the lawyers of Nepal take privilege, and we feel very happy to welcome our colleagues from Delhi to speak in our forum. And because they are here, I may take this opportunity to speak a few words about constitutional development in Nepal and the impact that we had, the influence that we had from the constitutional development in India in shaping our constitution. It's very important. Not many people in India know how much of influence the Indian constitutionalism had on the development of constitution of Nepal. I, being one of the constitutional lawyers who was involved in the process of drafting the constitution, I have to share some of these things with our guests from India so that they can also share what they have heard from us to their colleagues in India. First of all, when we decided to go for a federal constitution, we in Nepal didn't really actually know how the federalism works. We were throughout brought up in unified, unitary culture. So obviously, but there was one thing that Nepal as a nation is as diverse as India in terms of religion, culture, ethnicity. We have a lot of diversity like in India. So the only way to accommodate everybody's aspirations and at the same time keep them united, the only possible framework was federalism. And another important thing was that we were becoming federal state from a unitary state. We didn't become federal state out of independent states. So the process was very much, you know, similar to that of India, because India was also British used to rule. It was only in 1935 Act that they created provinces and divided the powers and went in a federal style. But before that, it was united by British invasion. British authorities united India, and then 1935 Indian Government Act came and then divided into provinces, divided the powers. All the different communities with different languages, cultures, and regional backgrounds, they have something or the other. They have a role to play, not only in democracy, but also in development. So we have created three tiers of government: local government, provincial government, and federal government. And you know, when I was in Delhi University, when I was doing BA Honours Politics, I happened to attend one talk program of Professor Rajnish Kothari. He was a great political scientist at that time. And I still remember he's saying that at that time, the division of power was basically focused on federal government, union government, and the state governments of India. There was not much mentioned about the local governments in India. So he's saying that if the Indian federalism has to survive, the decentralization of power through constitution has to take one more step down to the local level through the constitution. That is the only way we can ensure the continuity of Indian federalism. So he at that time had advocated for amendment of the constitution to allocate specific powers relevant for the local administration to the local governments through the constitution. And he has said that the state governments will never come forward to delegate or give away their powers to the local government. So constitution has to allocate the powers at the third level, at the grassroots level, to the local governments. You know, we will not wait for the state governments to enact the local government, the local governance act, and give up, share their powers to the local governments. We will do it right away through the constitution. In Indian constitution and politics, you know, we cannot avoid that. We realize that because we have open world, we have common culture, we share our religion, and we share Hindi songs and Hindi actors also. We have good source of entertainment from Bollywood. So this is the reality. So we even have a lot of influence from India, that is true. But we also influence India also, definitely. We are the Katena. Nepal is the country where your gods reside. You know, the South Indians come travel all the way to the Himalayas by way of pilgrimage to go to the Kailash, the homeland of Shiva. So, you know, we have also influence both ways.
We are expanding the relation of Nepal Bar Association because we do have a very high level lawyers, competent new lawyers, and we want to cross the national border in terms of sharing of our ideas and experiences. So in this process, I am sure that this platform will definitely strengthen the bond between the Nepal Bar Association and the Bar Association. So with these words, I request Advocate Jayanti Goel for your deliberation on the constitution and politics in South Asia and sharing experience with our senior advocates.
The office bearers of Nepal Bar Association and my friends and colleagues sitting in front of me, it is indeed an opportunity for me to come here and share my views. I'm very grateful and thankful to Nepal Bar Association, Rajkumar Thapaji, my old friend, and you all, because this is the land of what I consider. This is the land of spirituality. This is a powerhouse of spirituality from where the power generates to the entire globe. This is what is Nepal. From my childhood, I was in India, in West Bengal, in Calcutta. So we all brought up in a society where we were in every third or fourth house was a Nepali house. So we are very much accounted with the culture and the brotherhood of Nepalis. Still my young days when I used to go to school, I used to think Nepal is other than like other states in India. When I become growing up, I then know that this is a separate country. I think it has happened with some grown-up people also who visited India. I mean, in Nepal also in last few years ago, some film star also come. She has also made some comments. So this is not in a very negative sense, because we are so much close to Nepal that sometimes this official barriers and something else, it is totally different for us. Indeed, for the last few years, after a big struggle, after a long legal research, I was also a part of the process in Supreme Court to assist some lawyers to make out your constitution, who were making their suggestion to Nepal. So it is a very interesting thing where I have gone through the constitution of Nepal, constitution of India. So after, I think, a long battle in 2015, you have get a wonderful constitution. जैसे सुंदर आपका देश है, वैसे सुंदर आपको एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मिला है. सो लेट्स होप फॉर द बेस्ट दैट इन नियर फ्यूचर you can achieve the ultimate goal through this constitution. And is in my words, what is the ultimate goal? As I am an organizing secretary of Akhil Bharatiya Adhivakta Parishad, that is the largest lawyers organization in India. Right now, there are, as per the Bar Council of India record, there are 20 lakh lawyers in India. And most of the lawyers are our members. So it is a very huge organization. We have several parameters. We are working independently, only as a lawyer. We never share our dais with any kind of politician, whether it is of the ruling party or of the opposite party. We only allow the concerned law minister of Union of India or a particular state. Apart from that, we don't allow any sort of politician or political office bearer to share our dais, because we have a separate kind of thought. That I would like to share with you. So that's why I was telling, according to me, according to us, the ultimate goal of this parliamentary democracy of the constitution is Nyay Antim Vyakti Tak, the justice after the last man of the society, the faceless man of the society, the poor people of the society. When we will be able to deliver the justice to this last man of the society, antim vyakti tak, jab tak hum nyay nahi pahunchayenge, tab tak koi bhi parliament democracy mein vishwas rakhne wale log chain ki neend nahi so sakte. Is principle mein hum vishwas karte hain. First, when very keen in your Nepal constitution, I was going through the comparative analysis and all that. For the last few years, in the entire globe, we have worked on human rights, we have worked on fundamental rights, we have worked on lot of rights. But what about our duties? What about our duties of a citizen? What about our duties of a lawyer? We have to think about it. We can acquire lot of rights through revolution, through lot of things. But if we perform our duties properly, automatically lot of rights will be given to the common man. If I am a government servant, whether I am properly doing my duties, daily routine work, being an advocate, being a lawyer, whether I am doing my proper duty, whether I am doing my proper duty, I am doing justice to my client, I am doing justice to my country, I am doing justice to my society. We have a motto, we have an emblem of Akhil Bharatiya Adhivakta Parishad, and that is, in Devanagari, in Sanskrit, it is Nyaya Mama Dharma. It is our motto. Nyaya Mama Dharma. As a lawyer, we have no other religion. We have the only religion that we have to extend dharma. Dharma means not the religious means dharma. Dharma means the supreme thought of dharma, that is rule of law. That is called dharma. So that is our supreme duty of a lawyer, to extend rule of law to the common man of the society. Then only we can achieve whatever there is in our constitution or in your constitution. We work as a catalyst organization in India. Work as a catalyst organization. We work as a force behind the Sajjan Shakti, the positive source, who are working in the society for the good reason, for development of the society, whatever it has the color, but it is working for the poor man, working for the backward class, working for the tribal people, working for the other backward class, working for the entire society. So we are working as a catalyst organization. We are working as a cutting edge to this Sajjan Shakti, to this positive force. So we are working in that manner. Ultimately, we the lawyers in several time in Supreme Court of India, we have been described as a court officer. We are the court officer of the court. Unless we assist, there is no proper judgment comes out from the judiciary. So we have been considered as an important role in the judiciary to deliver judgment. We have the responsibility to strengthen the judiciary also, to strengthen the justice delivery system. And in order to strengthen the justice delivery system, we have to properly educate our lawyers. Because as we are coming out from the institution and joining the bar, starting our practice, furthermore, we rarely have the opportunity to update us. I think in very few countries, this kind of things are there where the lawyers been updated after starting practice. So we have to think about it. Though the topic constitution and politics in South Asia, I am taking it in a very different manner. The political system, the parliamentary democracy, the representative of the people, they are going to parliament, they are going to the assembly, they are doing job, it's a different kind of thing. But we the lawyers, we have to work and watchdog of the society. Whatever it is going on in the society, whatever it is going on in our nation, in our country, whatever it is going on poor people, on common people, whether it is in the forest or in the urban areas or in the urban slums or in the towns, we should be working as a watchdog of the society. We lawyers are considered as a social engineer. This is a very big thing. We are not a mere lawyer who are representing our clients in the court. We are the social engineer. So we have a great responsibility. As you will find in the entire globe, still now, India, Nepal, we are the underdeveloped countries. We are trying to develop. But wherever the developed countries are there, whether it has been Japan or China or American or Russia or Germany, you will find the backbone behind this development are all our lawyers from our community. We have a lot of responsibility towards our nation, towards our society. According to my language, ईश्वर हमें इसलिए पैदा नहीं किया था जो हम इस प्रोफेशन में आके और अपना पैसा कमा के इस जिंदगी को छोड़ के चले जाए. This was not the motto of Almighty. Only for making money, lot of other professions are there, whether it is legal or illegal. But the Almighty has assigned us in a profession where we are assisting the justice delivery system to give justice to the common man of the society. Hum nyay dene ka prakriya mein ek bahut bada stambh hai. According to me, there is a very big difference between the justice and nyay. What you can cover and extend through the word nyay, it is very big thing. But still our system is going through the justice. So our ultimate thing should be that the common people should get nyay. Sometimes nowadays we find the easy way to resolve the number of cases pending in the courts is to either take this way or that way and is to dispose of the matter and to bring out with a judgment and justice, whether it is giving nyay to that person who has come to the court with a lot of hope. When somebody feels he has been cheated or some illegality is there, his last resort is the court. After going through all kind of local mediation, local people's advice, the last resort is this court, this judiciary system. And if people doesn't have faith in this system, it will be dangerous. In some of the countries, in some of the places, it has already started. When people find that going to the court is unnecessary, spending money and time, why I will go to the court? Rather, I will find some other way where I have to contact some other means or some other gangs, pay them some money and get the things done. So if these things come started, this will be a disaster for the democratic system. This will be a disaster for the parliamentary democracy and for the judiciary too. So we have to be a watchdog in this arena, that the common people should have trust in the judiciary. The common people should have the trust in the justice delivery system. And we are a very important part of this system. As I was saying, that in our organization, in Akhil Bharatiya Adhivakta Parishad, what we used to do, that in every month, we used to organize a study circle, or what do you say, Swadhyay Mandal, study circle, in the court campus. So if it is once in a month, so it is 12 study circle in a year. So we used to advise that there should be 8 study circle from different parts of laws. One can be on civil law, one can be on criminal law, on taxation, on arbitration or other law, some practical laws on evidence, drafting, like this. Other 2 study circles should be on some national or local issues. And the rest 2 study circles will be for the training of the young advocates who intend to participate in the judicial exams. Because unless we prepare good advocates for the judiciary, you know, after passing through various sleepless nights with the briefs and books and everything, sometime we find that after arguing, everything goes on the head of the judge. And the labor settled by us for 1 month, 2 months, everything dissolves. So we need very good judges in judiciary. Unless and until we can provide very good judges in the judiciary, we can't get good justice. And we can't get good justice, we can't extend yeah to the last man of the society. So for that, we have to give some training to the young advocates who intend to be a judge. So it is our responsibility. We are getting them aware about these fundamental laws. We are holding these legal awareness camps, either with the help of a local organization or an NGO. Not a typical NGO which is made for making money. I'd like to make sure you that we are only working for the benefit of the society. Neither we are allowing any politician to come to our platform, neither we are getting or receiving any government aid. We never receive. All we used to contribute, all the lawyers in India, we are running on only on that. Because whenever you will get some aid from a government, you have to oblige something to the government. A government may do good job, a government may do bad job. But we have to take a very partial view towards the nation, towards the society. So we are working in this manner to give nyay to the last man of the society. If we find in our Nyaya Kendras that one has to go to the court, then we are bringing them to the court, we are contacting the legal services authorities, where the government is spending crores of rupees for this common man. But as lawyers are not there, some touts are making this money and even not giving, providing justice to these persons. So we have become a bridge between this legal services authority and the common people of the society. Apart from this kind of Nyaya Kendras, periodically we used to organize workshops, seminars, symposiums. Whether lawyer attends there, it is for 1 day, 2 day or 3 day, complete workshop. Recently we have, the last year we have 4 national workshops in India. One was on human rights, it was in Kanyakumari. Second was on young advocates, it was in Himachal Pradesh. So this kind of 4 workshops, and another was in Madhya Pradesh in Jabalpur, it was on Nyaya Kendra. So every year we used to organize this kind of workshops. Used to come in their own money and used to stay in our arrangement, but they have to provide the contribution. We would like to make each and every member of us to be a superb lawyer. Unless and until we can enrich our legal fraternity, our lawyers, brothers and sisters, we can't achieve something big. This is not a mere daily going to the court and coming back and having some fees in my pockets. We have been entrusted by the Almighty for a very bigger job, for a very bigger job of the mankind. And we are the professionals, only professionals in the world who have honored with the adjective learned. Only the lawyers are called the learned advocates, the learned lawyers. No other professionals are called. So we have been entrusted a very big responsibility. So we have to do our responsibility. We have to think in a very calculative manner. We have to do it with a vision. As a lawyers, 365 days we have the responsibility to work as a constituent assembly. Whatever the new bills are coming in, the either in the parliament or in the assembly, we have to go through the bills. We have to study it. Which lawyer have the concerned knowledge on this particular area? We have to consult with them. We have to take the knowledge from the senior advocates, from the dignitaries, from the law faculties, from the dignitaries of our faculties. Then we have to make a representation. If we find something, it is not adequate and not in the mankind of the common man, of the society, or with our culture, or with our whatever it is rooted with the grass. We, along with a very dedicated team, we used to be in front of these standing committee bodies. We used to give our suggestion. And in spite of that, if the bill is passed, if and it becomes a statute, we take the other way. We file a public interest litigation. We have the enormous power. What I consider, what 1 lakh, 1 lakh, more lakh, 10 lakh people can't do without a revolution, we few lawyers can do it with an appropriate application filing before a court and getting an appropriate order. And that also we can get it without any bloodshed. So we have an enormous power. So this enormous power should be channelized for the betterment of the state, for the betterment of the country, for the betterment of the society, and for the betterment of the last man of the society. Making think it's better. I should have a very big marble, white marble statue in my palace itself. So that sculpture was called, please come. He has come, he has talked to the king. I need a single white marble elephant statue within my premises of the palace. And then he said, okay, it's fine, Maharaj. Ho jayega, koi baat nahi. Then he asked, how many days you required, how much time you required? He thought and then told, Maharaj, I think I need 90 days to complete this statue. Then he told, okay, you just start your work. By tomorrow or day after tomorrow itself, I will bring that big single marble stone and you can't, put something, add to it. Within that single marble stone, you have to make that statue of the elephant. 10 days gone, 20 days gone, 30 days gone. That artist was not coming up. He's not coming to the palace. So then this Raja, this king think, what happened? He has assured me, but the 30 days are gone, he didn't turn up. So he then sent some of his soldiers, go and bring him. They went to him. Then he told, no, you assure to Raja that I will come within 10 days and I'll start my work. And ultimately, at the day 60 days has crossed, he has come to the palace. Then he starts his work with his all accessories, with a hammer or something else. He started his work. And as 89 days was over, the complete beautiful marble statue of the white single stone, it was done. It was a marvelous statue. King was very much happy. He started celebration in his entire kingdom. In a particular day, he inaugurated the statue of this single white marble stone, this elephant statue. He gave lot of golden coin, Swarna Mudra, to this sculpture. Then he asked a question to the sculpture. Now you tell me, when you are aware that you can complete it within 30 days, why you have taken 90 days of time? Then he replied, it is a very simple thing. For the first 60 days, I have thought, I have made my vision that in that particular stone, where will be the head, where will be the tail, where will be the legs and other things. So it takes 60 days to make the vision. And the another 30 days, it was very simple. Only I have cut off the non-elephant from that stone. So my sisters and brothers, your that 60 days work of the vision and bringing your constitution has been done by your dignitaries. And now the 30 days work is left with us to give the constitution a real effect and giving the Nyaya to the Antim Vyakti. This is our vision which has been bring up from our luminaries and the dignitaries. So we have to give in the practical implementation of this 30 days work.
Mr. Joy, you talked about the role of the lawyers and how the how your institution is working to encourage the lawyers in coming to practice and giving the opportunity for the young lawyers. We have a unique and uncontested history in Nepalese context. The Nepalese lawyers, the performance and the struggle that Nepalese lawyers, our pioneers, they have done in the whole political movement of this country is uncontested. We were the leading civil society in all democratic movement of this country, and Nepal Bar Association was the leading one. Based on that fact, that Nepal Bar Association has a wider influence in all in the judiciary, even in the executive, and in all constitution making process. When we made up the interim constitution after the establishment of the monarch, the most of the framer of the interim constitutions were the lawyers, and that dignity, that dignified professions is also recognized under the constitution of Nepal. So we are carrying out noble professions, that our profession is recognized in the constitution, and it's only the lawyers and advocates who are recognized constitution. So we are carrying the constitutional profession. And to make this possible, we have a very, very senior lawyers who did a very hard struggle. We are the young lawyers, so we didn't have to take much efforts to come into the profession. But the very pioneer lawyers, like the former speaker of the parliament, senior advocate Damana Kumana, who were the leaders of these bar associations, made a historical recognitions for the Nepalese lawyers in this one. And I'm also very happy to know that how your institutions work with the lawyers. Respected. This is a new figure of the legal profession, Damana Kumana, to have a very brief comment and brief note on the
stress on justice to the last man. That's what Ved also says, prescribes. But the ways are different. The very existence of the state is for justice. If there is no justice, if justice, if common men are deprived of justice, there is no sense of statehood. That being the case, I was really impressed the way you presented the thing. The last man at the bottom, that's what I have learned from Gandhi literature. Gandhi always stressed on the last man at the bottom. Sabse niche peer ka aadmi. So, the very purpose of justice is to deliver justice to the last man, to the man at the bottom. So, you made very right stress on that. The real purpose, objective of the justice. Who really deserve the justice and who is deprived of justice? And our institutions are capable of delivering just justice that the last man expects from the state and the state president. What is it? So, on the other hand, I found from your presentation, you are very much an organizer. Not only a lawyer, but an organizer. You are the leader of the organization, and that gives greater sense to us that relation between us, fraternal relation between your organization and our organization, Nepal Federation, will be better in days to come. I wish well to our organization and to the two lawyers visiting, and wish you all the best to the new India now you are after this election. Thank you.
I invite the Vice President of Nepal Bar Association, Suri Gautrai, for a short comment from the Nepal Bar Association.
First of all, Rajkumar Ji, my lecturer Rajkumar Ji, the Alibadi contribution to our lesson. I'm going to address the Samanda Samiti, Kasam, Ju, Sachim Ji, and the Sati Ali. I'm going to address the Amantran Gornabo. हामीले त्यहाँको एडवोकेट काउन्सिल प्लस इन्डियाको उहाँहरूले गरेका कन्ट्रिब्युसनहरूको बारेमा हामीले सुन्ने अवसर प्राप्त गऱ्यौँ. मलाई लाग्छ हामीसँग धेरै समय छैन. हाम्रा आदरणीय पूर्व सभाको दमन दाईले धेरै कुराहरू राखिसक्नु भएको छ. मैले यहाँहरू समक्ष धेरै समय लिन चाहन्न. वास्तवमा लयरहरूको अर्गनाइजेसन 50,000 कानुन व्यवसायहरूको अर्गनाइजेसन भन्नुभयो उहाँले एडभोकेट काउन्सिल अफ इन्डिया. मलाई खुसी लाग्यो त्यहाँको महत्त्वपूर्ण व्यक्ति हामीसँग उपस्थित हुनुभयो र त्यहाँका एक्सपिरियन्सहरू हामीलाई सुनाउनु भयो. नेपाल बार एसोसिएसनमा जम्मा 17,000 कानुन व्यवसायहरू हामी यहाँ छौँ. त्यसको प्रतिनिधित्व एउटा केन्द्रीय बार नेपाल बार एसोसिएसनले गर्छ. नेपाल बार एसोसिएसन एउटा कमन अर्गनाइजेसन वी क्यान से अल्सो अम्ब्रेला अर्गनाइजेसन. यो कुनै पोलिटिकल अर्गनाइजेसन होइन. यसले कुनै पोलिटिकल विचारधाराहरू राख्दैन. यहाँले भने जस्तो हामी पनि विशुद्ध प्रोफेसनल अनि व्यवसायिक एकाडेमिक लयरहरूको यो अर्गनाइजेसन भएको कारणले हाम्रो बिचमा आपसी सम्बन्ध स्थापित गर्ने, आपसी सम्बन्ध विस्तार गर्ने र दुवै देशका कानुन व्यवसायहरू मात्र नभएर जनताको निम्ति जनताको हित हुने कार्यक्रमहरूमा हामीले सहकार्य गर्न सकौँ यसको निम्ति म यो विनम्र निवेदन पनि गर्न चाहन्छु. हाम्रो सम्बन्ध गाढा रहनेछ. यो अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय सम्बन्ध समितिले जुन एउटा रोल प्ले गरेको छ, जुन भूमिका निर्वाह गरेको छ, त्यसको निम्ति म यो सम्बन्ध समितिलाई समेत धन्यवाद दिन चाहन्छु. नेपाल बार एसोसिएसनले चाँडै नै फेरि समितिहरू गठन गर्न गइरहेको छ. मलाई लाग्छ हामीले आगामी नेपाल बार एसोसिएसनको केन्द्रीय समितिको बैठकमा यो समितिहरूलाई फेरि पुनर्गठन गर्नेछौँ. त्यस क्रममा यो महत्त्वपूर्ण भूमिका निर्वाह गर्नुहुने यहाँहरूको निश्चय नै महत्त्वपूर्ण भूमिका फेरि पनि निर्वाह गर्नुपर्ने अवस्था सिर्जना हुनेछ. त्यसको निम्ति म फेरि पनि यहाँहरूलाई धन्यवाद दिँदै बिदा हुन चाहन्छु. धन्यवाद.